Hi everybody, thank you so much for being here today. I'm going to be doing a celebrity psychic reading on Halsey. So I do not know much about Halsey. This was requested and I'm hoping you guys enjoy. And if you guys would like to book your own personal psychic reading, everything is in the description box below. All right, so without even reading into this woman, I see a lot of like, it's almost like they want me to call it like an alternative type of occult practices. I don't really feel like she's the type of person to do rituals, but there's more of a participation in ceremonies, and a ceremony is something that will happen amongst two or more people. A ceremony is more about a collective. Anyway, what I'm getting from Halsey by just looking at her is gender issues. I don't know much about her. I'm getting just, she's been a participant in a lot of occult ceremonies. And there's almost a part of her soul that is trapped in astral that's almost trying to like communicate with me. But this is all very deep into her, into who she is as a soul. On a very superficial plane, I feel like she is actually a very nice person if you were to meet her. She has a big issue with people being unorganized. She can be the type of person that claps back at people who are insultive or unorganized. However, I'm getting more of a softer heart from her in at her core. Sorry, I'm just looking at a few pictures so I can get the most accurate reading. I'm getting a lot of like celestial energy. She might work with celestial magic. It's very common in celestial magic for people to be participants of ceremonies. And in my head, I'm just seeing all these things that she's done with other people that, you know, have the same goal in mind. I feel like she's always known that she was going to be very famous, like even as a young adult. I'm also hearing she has some type of contact with extraterrestrials that have told her this is what you're going to do in your life. And some people refer to when we first incarnate here that we have some type of amnesia, that we forgot our soul origin, soulmates that we've had in the past, we forgot about them, what we've done in our past lives. So they would refer to this as like an amnesia that comes up to us when we incarnate on Earth. I don't really feel like she's exactly had that amnesia. And some people haven't, like me for example, and most other psychics. We remember a lot of our past lives. For her, I'm getting more so that she does remember why she's here. And she does remember her past lives. And she does remember her contact with extraterrestrials. And I feel like she has welcomed them into her life. And a big reason why she is so famous and successful is because she has been in contact with them. And she has helped, she has let them help her achieve what she wanted in her career. I'm going to be honest with everybody. There are two different routes that the Earth is really trying to go in. I can see the path that she is on. And I could see what they are asking of her. And it's not exactly as simple as some people may say, that all these celebrities like sell their soul to the devil or something. It's not exactly as simple as that. With spirituality, whether it be dark or light, it's all very complex. Leaders have a very different vision, whether they're dark leaders or light leaders, have a very different vision, most commonly darker leaders, of what Earth and our consciousness should be. However, it is mostly leading to the same goal of us lowering our vibration as collective. And that is just kind of what I'm seeing for Halsey, that's one of her missions, to bring very destructive ideals about identity to us. And we may see that, we may have already seen that, we may see that later on with her. However, I don't feel like She is exactly here to help anybody. I feel like she is here, and she is as successful as she is to help a extraterrestrial plan for our planet. Like one of the Greys type of plan, if you guys can get what I'm saying with that. But it's obviously pretty common for celebrities to adhere to a plan such as that. So Halsey's partner, romantic interest, is his name is Olive Aydin. I think that's how you say his name. Aydin. From what I'm getting about this relationship is that he is definitely toxic. He is insecure with himself. And I'm getting kind of a more narcissistic energy from him. This relationship, I feel like this relationship has a lot of highs and lows, and Halsey appreciates that, and I'm hearing her say, like, I'm not gonna change, so let me just settle for this, or I'm not gonna, something about resistance to changing men that she's interested in, and acceptance of that resistance. I'm seeing like a lot of issues that she has to deal with this man because he is very insecure and also kind of narcissistic. So, I feel like for her, she feels as though Aydin, I think this is how he pronounced his name, is more like he has very bratty moments and has a very childish attitude at times. I feel like she kind of feels as though he's like a second son to her. However, she knows that she's chosen this person, so she's not going to leave. I do not see them staying together forever. I do see her actually breaking up with him at some point. And becoming a single mother. Yeah, I don't see this relationship lasting at all. I think she's just more so putting up with him instead of enjoying the relationship between them, especially now because they have a child together. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed. If you would like to have a reading of your own, everything is in the description below. Bye!